All right, we need to find a definite integral, that's an integral with limits, that expresses the area of the region between these two functions. Let's just make a really quick sketch of these two functions. The function x squared minus 1 is just an upward opening parabola that's shifted down 1 unit. That would look something like this. The function y equals 6 is just a horizontal line that passes through the y value y equals 6. Now the area between any two curves can be represented by an integral. In this case, we have one function that's obviously the top function and one function that is obviously the bottom function. In this case, the area is going to be represented by the integral of the top function minus the bottom function. And the limits of integration are going to be given by the lowest value of x in this region over here and the highest value of x in this region here. And how do we find the smallest and largest value of x in this region? Well, it occurs where these two functions intersect each other. So we can set these two functions equal to each other. That's x squared minus 1 equals 6. And we can solve for x. When we solve for x, we get plus and minus the square root of 7. And those become our upper and lower limits of integration. Let's now take this integral and simplify it and find its value. Taking 6 minus x squared minus 1 is just going to give us a 7 minus x squared dx. Integrating that then gives us 7x minus 1/3 x cubed, evaluated from negative root 7 to positive root 7. Evaluating that antiderivative at the upper limit and lower limit of integration and subtracting gives us this line. And you can see that we can combine our like terms. 7 root 7 plus 7 root 7 is 14 root 7. Likewise, negative 1/3 root 7 cubed minus another 1/3 root 7 cubed gives us negative 2/3 root 7 cubed. We can simplify a bit more though. The square root of 7 cubed can be written as the square root of 7 squared times the square root of 7. That's just 7 root 7. So we can copy down our first term, and turning this here into 7 root 7 gives us 14/3 root 7. And finally, we can combine these two terms because they're like terms now. They both have a root 7. And if we do that, we are going to get 28/3 root 7. That was just finding a common denominator with our 14. We would have to multiply this 14 by a 3 over 3 and subtract. And that is going to be our final answer. And I think that that's going to do it for that problem.